Thank you, Adam. Lyell is so excited and so proud to be here today. Good morning, everyone. I'm going to kick us off with some interesting, if sobering, facts about cancer. First one is that 40 out of 100 of us will actually get cancer in our lifetimes. That means, just statistically, based on the size of this room, 2,000 of us will get cancer. On the flip side, 250 of us are already cancer survivors. But even if you're able to avoid getting the disease in your lifetime, you'll probably still have intimate knowledge of it, because 90% of us will take care of a loved one with cancer at some point in our life. Now, the biotechnology industry is making progress in developing new therapies for cancer. And cell therapy is the next frontier. And what that means is we use your body's immune cells to make new, effective medicines. Now, you may be surprised to hear that some blood cancers, like lymphoma, can be completely cured with one dose of cell therapy. Now, that's something that was completely unimaginable 10 or 15 years ago. The problem is that most cancers aren't blood cancers. In fact, 90% of all cancers are solid tumor cancers, like liver, lung, colon, and ovarian. And for these types of cancers, cell therapy has not yet been successful. 4 years ago, we founded Lyell to change all of that. Now, I'm going to give you just a 30-second biology lesson here. You might be surprised to learn that when your T cells are trying to fight off a solid tumor, they actually become exhausted, and that is a scientific term. The tumor is so clever that it actually pushes the T cell into this dysfunctional state. It's no longer potent, and it can't actually eradicate the cancer. But at Lyell, we have genetic and epigenetic reprogramming technologies that allow us to endow entire populations of T cells with the ability to resist exhaustion, which means they maintain their functionality, they maintain their potency, and they maintain their cancer-killing ability. And we are testing those T cell therapies in the clinic today. So how does that actually happen? How does that start? Well, it starts with a patient, and that patient gives us their cells. So they're trusting us with their cells. And I think from the patient perspective, it's probably, you know, don't lose my cells or don't mix them up with somebody else's. But from our perspective, it's actually much more complicated. We need to take those cells, we need to transport them across state lines, get them to a manufacturing facility where they're moved around lots of different rooms. We have to apply our reprogramming technologies. Then we have to check them once, twice, three times, make sure that they adhere to every regulatory spec that we're bound by, package them all up, get them back across state lines, and then reinfuse them into the patient as medicine. So this is an incredibly complex process, and we knew we needed to be able to control all of the details. So we built our own manufacturing facility, the Life Manufacturing Facility. And given the complexity of the process and just the massive amounts of data that cell therapy generates, we knew that AWS was the only, the obvious choice for a strategic cloud provider. And together, we've implemented digital technologies and cloud infrastructure that really form the backbone of this facility. We believe that the Life facility is the only cell therapy facility to benefit from AWS's deep knowledge of Internet of Things, cloud infrastructure, and advanced analytics. Now, when we first started working with AWS, we knew that we would benefit from the deep resident expertise in the healthcare and life sciences team. But we also got ready access to a broad array of partners, and this really helped accelerate the build of the Life facility because we were able to rapidly integrate multiple complex systems. So I'd like to spend just a minute talking about how we worked with AWS. What you're seeing here is a vastly simplified version of the patient journey. These are all the steps that I discussed earlier. And there's lots of opportunity for variability here. And in our industry, that's just unacceptable. And so we knew that for each step of the way, we had to have visibility. And when I say visibility, what you should hear is data. We needed to know not just where the cells are, but what's happening to them as they go from being exhausted T cells into cancer-killing cells. So how did we do that? it wasn't actually intuitive. And when we started off, we really had to suspend all of our disbelief about how we should build a manufacturing facility, jettison all the preconceived notions and biases. And AWS helped us to do that by guiding us through what they called an art of the possible workshop. And that really guided our development of the facility and our thinking. So thanks to AWS and the deep expertise in Internet of Things, we created a solution on AWS that captures data from all of our enterprise applications, our instruments, our equipment, our bioreactors, and we take all of that data and we can push it to AWS real time. And what that does, it means that we can actually access that data real time, and we can do all of the critical correlative analyses that we need to do to ensure that the manufacturing of the product, the medicine, is actually going the way we need it to. But it also allows us to understand more about the biology of the cells, which is great for cancer. So how does this actually manifest for a life employee? These could be batch records from medicine that's being manufactured for a patient. And a life employee can actually monitor that real time on their phone. So they can be at the grocery store, they can be watching movies on the couch, and if something goes wrong with a batch, they'll know, and they can address it immediately. And I know if these were my cells, or if they were my mom's cells, I would be really happy with this level of monitoring and careful decision making. Another way that our work manifests in the life facility is what we call life mission control. And this is a centralized location within the manufacturing facility where we have these giant interactive electronic dashboards. And the teams actually gather here on a daily basis to think through the operations of the facility. They gather when there's a problem and even if we're just trying to improve a process. And that's because all of the data is quite literally at their fingertips. And not just for the batch that they're working on for today, but a historical one or an engineering one, anything that they need to access in order to improve the process or find a solution. Everything that we've done with AWS was designed to scale us for the future. We're testing our therapies in 4 different solid tumor indications today. But if we're successful, we'll rapidly expand into additional indications. And that means larger trials and ultimately commercialization. And AWS will be with us for every step of the journey. Remember those sobering numbers I shared with you at the beginning of the presentation? Well, if there's one thing that you remember from my talk today, I hope it is that AWS and Lyell are enabling transformative innovation at the intersection of technology and biology. And our goal is nothing less than to turn cancer patients into cancer survivors. Thank you for your time.